The PlayStation Portable is one of the most beloved handheld consoles of all time, having sold over 80 million units worldwide. In this video, I'm going to show you how to take that ever-popular PlayStation Portable, install RetroArch on it, and start playing retro games right away in just a matter of minutes. And it all starts right now. Hey there, if it's your first time here, my name is Blaine, and my channel is all about helping you get the most out of your video game experiences. If you like original content about restorations, repairs, mods, product reviews, and other great video game content, smash that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss out. Let's get RetroArch installed on your PlayStation Portable. You'll need to have a PlayStation Portable running custom firmware, something like Infinity and Pro-C2, in order for RetroArch to install and work. If you need help doing this, I have a video for you linked in the description below. The PSP version of RetroArch is hosted right on the RetroArch website. I've got it linked for you down in the description below. To get to the PSP version, navigate to the download section. From here, scroll down until you get to the section where you see the PSP logo. Click on the download link underneath PSP to grab the PSP version of RetroArch. Once you have RetroArch downloaded, connect your PSP to your computer over USB. If you look here in the downloads folder, you'll see RetroArch.7z that you just downloaded, but I also have two folders containing some ROMs in them to copy over to RetroArch. Go ahead and extract RetroArch.7z using your favorite 7z extraction software. And you can extract a folder right into downloads for this. Once you've uncompressed a compressed volume, I recommend deleting that compressed volume in order to eliminate confusion moving forward. Let's take a look at how ROMs are organized within RetroArch for the PSP. Essentially, you can just keep your ROMs in individual folders like you see here. Here's NES, and I have RBI Baseball in here for an example. And then I have a folder called Super Nintendo, and that folder has Super Mario World in it, as an example. You can take these folders and just put them right inside RetroArch, and we'll look at why that's helpful in just a moment when you get it loaded onto your PSP. So here, I'm just dragging these folders and dropping them right into the RetroArch folder. Once you have your ROMs and folders established inside the RetroArch folder, copy the RetroArch folder. Once you have the folder copied, you need to navigate to your PSP's memory card, or in the case of a PSP Go, its internal storage. For this example, I'll be using the PSP's memory card. And it's this drive right here. Once you double-click into the drive, you should see the PSP folder. Navigate to that folder and double-click in. From here, you should see a folder called Game. Navigate to it and double-click in. This is the folder where you want to paste RetroArch. With RetroArch put in place, all you need to do at this point is just close out File Explorer and disconnect your PSP from your computer. Let's go onto your PSP and get things rolling. With your PSP disconnected from your computer, you should be at this screen for the USB connection. Scroll over to the right until you get to the Games tab at the top of the cross media bar. You'll find RetroArch either on the memory stick or in the system storage, depending upon the type of PSP you have and where you put it. In this case, it's on the memory stick, selected with the X button. And there's RetroArch. To launch RetroArch for the first time, select it with the X button. Once RetroArch loads, as a quick note, the X button and circle button change functions. So in other words, circle is now for selecting things and X is for going back. You can also configure this in the main menu if it's not to your liking. First, you'll need to load a core. Select Load Core with the circle button to continue. For this demonstration, I'm going to load RBI Baseball for the NES. Scroll down until you get to the core that you want to use with the particular game system that you're planning to launch a ROM for. In this case, it's going to be the Nintendo NES system, and I'm going to select Quick NES from the list of cores. Use the D-pad to scroll down to the core you want, highlight it with the arrow, and select it with the circle button to continue. Now you're ready to load a game. Scroll down until you get to Load Content and select it with the circle button to continue. From here, you'll be asked to identify the location where your ROMs are located. In this case, it's on the memory stick, which is indicated below as MS0. Scroll down until you get to either the MS for memory stick or the internal storage, and select it with the circle button. From here, you'll see the root of the memory stick, which is where you see the PSP folder. The easiest way to get to the ROMs where you put them is just to select Parent Directory with the circle button. And bam, there are the folders that you put inside RetroArch. So all you have to do is just scroll down to the folder that has the ROMs that you want, in this case, NES, select it with the circle button, and you'll see the list of games inside your folder. We're going to run RBI Baseball, so scroll down to RBI Baseball, select it with the circle button. And from here, it's literally just a matter of pressing the circle button through the remaining menus. Press circle for browse, circle for the name of the ROM that you want to launch, and circle again. After a brief load time in which you'll see that menu flash back up and then disappear back off screen, your game will fire right up. You can control it like you normally would on an NES by using the D-pad and the buttons on your PlayStation Portable, and to exit back to the main menu, hold Start and Select for several seconds. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel while you're here so you don't miss out on great original video game content as it's posted. And check out this video here, shown on screen and linked in the pinned comments and description below for more great content. Thanks so much. I'll look forward to seeing you in the next video.